Are you ready to have salmon and sliced beef dressed just that bit differently? Well, in Niki Hill's photography, fashion, desire and consumerism are explored in a kind of a raw food sandwich. Let's find out more. Welcome to the show. Niki, you've got a face like, oh, you've never heard it described like that.
I haven't.
I think it suits it perfectly though. Now, let's look at you though. You started off, you were a graphic designer for years.
Yes, I was, yeah.
And so what made you move into creating your own art?
Well, I'd always wanted to do a fine arts degree, so I came to a point where I decided I better start really living and doing what I want to do. So that was sort of like the starting point for getting into Elam, and then all the other thing I really always really wanted to do was the lighting studio and photography. So it sort of, you know, came together in a big way.
Both of them come together well. Well, let's have a look at some of your art, because we've had a great week looking at it and talking about it. What, the fish shoe. Where did this idea come from?
Well, it's a start, it sort of starts in a dream, and then I kind of was looking at why these images come to me in dreams, and looking at the subconscious and how we sort of are led by our subconscious to things, and then I started looking at why I like looking at fashion and those high fashion items and things like that, and then to put those two subjects together is quite a bizarre thing to do, and it sort of subverts this sort of nature of what we're doing, you know. And I was looking at the culture that we live in and how we're sort of led by those subconscious desires to want the fashion item, and so the raw product subverts the fashion, and it makes us question why we're doing what we're doing. So it's sort of quite quirky dream state stuff.
Do you find, because I mean, I find with some of your art, I look at it and it takes me a few seconds to realise what I'm actually looking at as well. Do a lot of people have that reaction?
Yeah, they do. That's what I'm playing on. I'm playing on that allure, you know, that you want to look at those things and decide that, you know, you get a shock when you realise what I've made it out of.
And of course, these are meat shoes. Do you like fashion?
I do. I love looking and at fashion. I must admit, I find the high heel shoes hard to wear.
Everyone does.
I know.
So let's have a look at some more, because it just, it seems like you've got so many different ideas of what you're doing with it as well. Now, what are these made out of?
That's dragon fruit. Shoe. I've made it from the skin of the dragon fruit. It's a pitaya. It's an Asian fruit.
Right.
Yeah, we find it in our local marketplace in the summertime.
Yeah. Is that how you get the ideas as well? You're just walking around the supermarket and you think, I'm going to turn that into art.
Yeah. First they start in this dream state, so I'm sketching and coming up with concepts, and then I go looking to see what I can find to sort of make these things come to real life.
What are they made out of?
That one is actually shattered glass mirror, and there's a bacon lining on the inside. So it's sort of that one's about shattering the dreams. You know, you know that the princess or the Cinderella shoe. You know that sort of your perceptions of these dreams and ideals that you have about life and how they just get smashed. But I've done it in a wonderful way. It's quite bizarre.
And you've got these little pieces which are made from hearts, aren't they?
Yeah, a heart, a pig's heart, and it's a lamb's or sheep kidney on there.
I love your art. Who do you think will enjoy the exhibition?
Well, I've had quite a few people interested in the exhibition already. I think it has a general appeal as well as, you know, meeting the sort of higher fine art criteria. So it's sort of, I like to think that it's sort of generally quite interesting to most people.
It's made all of us for the last week go, whoa, every time we see it. It's amazing. Thank you so much for coming in, and best of luck for the future as well.
Thank you.